Yo, what's up, fan base? It's your boy Blaze Hollow coming at you with another What If. This time I would bring you What If Deku at All For One Part 14, but I have a few more things I want to say before we actually get into the story. And that is that I'm properly sorry and I bow my head to my loyal fan base who have been sticking through all this hardship for not getting any uploads anytime soon. The reason is my head has not been in the right place. My family member has actually been in the hospital recently for surgery that she luckily came through, and I've been very busy with work. I do know that I continue to try to work on my scripts as best I can and try to find time to record for you guys, so please hang in there and do know that I will try to upload, but it will not be as frequently as you want. So if any of you are still here, please start that intro and get into that story. See me do the fuck, bitch. Crazy, saying that she hate me. Obliterate the pussy, feral animal with rabies. Yo, bitch, fucking dirty. She got scabies. Wipe the thotty out of that trench with some babies. Everyone thinking that they gon' save me. Depressive motherfucker, I don't wanna steal. As dust was clearing in the air, you could see a red tint of blood mixing in with the dirt as everybody was behind cover. Only one person stood in the middle of that dust cloud, screaming at the top of his lung, hoping to hear an answer. It was Izuku, hoping to hear Titan's voice. Come on, say something, brother. I need to hear your voice, even if it means you have to twitch one of your transformation fingers to let me know that you're alive out there. Jinzo was getting up after being tackled by Yumi as they crash landed into one of the buildings as he was trying to get up off of her. As he looks at her, she seems to be very bad. Wounded as he puts her gently on her side as he then goes outside the building to see one of his closest friends yelling at the top of his lungs. He then looks back at Yumi for a second, noticing the chunks of glass in her wings, but then he realized that he had to help Izuku as he rushed out and put his hands on his shoulder, trying to get him to stop yelling. He's going to be okay. If he was going to die, he would have been killed off very long ago. For one thing, came out of the rubble as he was dusting himself off. Well, he should actually survive. It looked like he was hit with an AoE strike, not a concentrated strike. Izuku was a little bit confused, wondering why that whole statement matters. Why does it matter if it's concentrated or all over the place? Didn't you see the size of that explosion? For one looked at both of the boys with a very serious expression, like they need to listen and not say anything. Because you can destroy the transformed body as much as you want, but as long as they don't attack the neck, because that's where the original body is. Since they destroyed the main chest cavity and part of the face with that blast, it means that the body may be a little bit rattled, but he should be alright. Ina then came out of nowhere as she actually was covered in dirt and blood as her eye actually looked like it was heavily damaged. I'm glad I found you guys because I saw something out there running from the destroyed body. Yuna fell off of the stone pile that she was on top of, only to be caught bridal style by Izuku. She was wiping the dirt off of her face, trying to see if she was still conscious, only to hear a little bit of coughing. Just hang in there, I'll bring you over to medic in a minute, but I need you to tell me what you saw out there. Yuna was breathing heavily as she was trying to remember what she saw out there exactly. Luxfire came out of the dust cloud near the edge of the explosion radius, which seemed to be holding a giant crystal on his back. What made the situation worse is all the robots were chasing after him, so I came to try to find anybody that I could so we can go help him. Medic then walked up as she actually had Shoto on a giant piece of metal dragging behind her, which made her very annoyed, but she knew what she got herself into. Alright, now we have two people down. We're losing a lot of power and fast, along with most of the replicas we're bringing brought down. Only ones that are left out are me, All For One, and Firefox. I actually could count the casualties as two or three people being down if I look at it right now. Jinzo actually interrupted Medic so he can actually give her more information about what's been going on so he can also get his point across. Losing those clone bodies that he makes for your guys actually isn't a bad thing, it just means that Izuku's actually getting back to his true strength. The fact that actually four of us is down because Titan's actually been taken out of the fight along with Mita because of her critical injuries. And if you follow me back to where I was before, we'll find an unconscious Yumi with very heavily damaged wings. And to also make things worse, I don't know how much time we have left until we actually get out of this test because all of our numbers keep on dropping like flies, and we keep on getting more enemies coming at us in stronger forces. While they are having this conversation, they go back to the building that Yumi is unconscious and as Medic actually sets up her whole situation ready to fix up everybody's injuries. But everybody noticed that Izuku was getting ready to head out to go find Foxfire, only to be stopped by All For One. Before you do anything, there is one spirit that you need to talk to that could try to help us change the tide of this battle. Izuku had a look of annoyance and anger, thinking about what he has to do instead of what he wants to do. Why do we need the Gold King so badly? If we need to use Gold Touch so badly, I can just use it myself. All For One just gave a very disappointed look as he just shook his head back and forth. If that's the case, why haven't you been using it this entire time? Something about Gold Touch just doesn't seem to synchronize with you very well. So unless you can give me a good enough reason, I think you need to sit back and try to contact with him, because if we continue to keep on running like this, we'll run out of forces real quick. Because look around, all of your forces are weakened and tired. If we don't get any more reinforcements while this timer is going, we are going to all pop. possibly be killed. Enso stepped up to the both of them as he put his arms on both of their chests, separating them away from one another. You also have to remember that this is also not a real fight. It has a time limit, like you have said before. All we need to do is try to find Foxfire along with the crystal and wondering why he's carrying it around with him, while also trying to avoid the rest of the robots that might be out there while we try to get back to base, because I think we have enough points already to pass. All For One was thinking about it, but eventually just gave in because he didn't think that it was possible that the school would get away with killing any of its applicants. Alright, the three of us will head out, but we'll try to avoid combat at all costs, but if it does come down to it, we will fight down to our last breath. And so did like the plan of not having to fight since most of the group was already tired and hurt. Alright, let's head out. We're losing time because we don't know what those robots could be doing to Foxfire right now. It took about 5 minutes of running throughout the city to find Foxfire as they actually were able to see that he was still being chased by three-pointer robots as he was running into an alleyway. But as soon as that happened, All For One decided to jump down and strike at all the robots with his air cannon, blasting them in all different directions. That's when Shinso and Izuku decide to actually jump down and get a closer look at the crystal. That's when they see Titan on the inside of the crystal actually regenerating his body from the blast wounds. Izuku had tears in his eyes as he actually got down on his knees next to the crystal as he was just so happy to see that Titan was actually going to be okay. Thank God that you're going to be okay. I'm sorry that I keep on dragging you into my problems. Shinso actually had a tick mark on his forehead as he actually punched Izuku in the back of the head, making him slam into the crystal. Sorry about that, but that's probably Titan's answer to that stupid statement that you keep on saying out loud. You can't keep on blaming yourself every time that we get hurt. We chose to get into this line of work. You didn't force us to. Foxfire was actually smiling at the group, happy to see them as he was holding onto one of his arms that was dislocated. I have to tell you that this was one of the greatest escape tricks that I've ever done in my life. At the last second, Titan ejected himself from his transformation body, slamming himself into me and taking most of the force of the concussional damage that the explosion was occurring. When the smoke cleared, this crystal started to form all around his body, so I decided to pick it up and carry him away from all the danger. But that's when the robots started to attack again, so I ran for my life, and thankfully that I ran into you guys before they actually were able to fully catch me. Izuku composed himself as he got back onto his feet. You did good. You can return to the others now and get some rest. We can take it from here. Foxfire actually started to disappear while the rest of the group was actually picking up the crystal and starting to head back to where Medic was. Only to hear the sound of somebody yelling as they actually were halfway back to their destination and then started to clean out their ears so they can hear what the speakers were saying properly. As they heard the speakers say that time is up, that all applicants should be heading back to the starting point. Izuku breathed a sigh of relief, actually happy that the test was over finally. Let's hurry up and grab the others so we can finally get away from this nightmare. All For One was starting to get really concerned about dealing with the heroes that might be showing up here soon as he started to fade away. Sorry, I don't want to seem like I'm being lazy, and trust me, I truly do want to help carry back the crystal, but I'd rather not deal with all the heroes stopping me every 5 seconds to ask me questions. But both of them nod as they understood as they finally made it back to the destroyed building, seeing Medic finish up all the patch up on the three unconscious people. But before anything else could be said, they could hear a voice from outside the building that no one could recognize at first until they turn around, seeing one of their most favorite allies and wearing his signature plague doctor mask. You kids truly give me a heart attack sometimes, but I'm really happy to see that you're all alright. Shinso just puts down the crystal as he sits down on top of it. Well, at least we'll be leaving here with no injuries thanks to you overall, well, except for the person that I'm sitting on. Izuku was chuckling a little bit, thinking about how Titan is going to react when he gets out of there. You know that if he's conscious in there and when he fully wakes up, he's going to pick you up and throw you through a couple of walls in anger. Overhaul started to take off his glove as he walked past both of the boys and then looked over at the unconscious children, trying to see which one had the worst condition. He then noticed how bad Humi's condition was as he put his hand on the back of her head as she disappeared for a few seconds, then reappeared. Here we go, one down, but I need a few minutes to let my skin irritation go down because it really irritates me when I use my quark. Medic just shook her head, but was happy that she can finally stop what she's been doing all day. I could technically make you a special moisturizer that could help you deal with the irritation a little bit, but I don't have the materials with me at this time, so maybe next time we meet, I could help you with that. Overhaul just had a smirk underneath his plaid doctor's mattress, thinking about having a moisturizer helping him with his irritation. Well, if you leave me with a list of materials that you're going to need, I'll make sure to have them ready for the next time we see each other. Medic walked over to Overhaul and reached into his coat as she grabbed his phone and then typed in the list of materials that he's going to need. There, I typed in the entire process on how to make the moisturizer along with every ingredient that you're going to need to make it. After a few more minutes of chit-chat and Overhaul fixing up all the unconscious people except for Titan, who was still stuck inside of his crystal. When they finally came out of the building carrying Titan's crystal, they noticed a bunch of heroes keeping their distance but were surveying the area. When they all look at the sky, they actually see Endeavor coming down to land with a smile on his his face, but also a little bit concerned for everybody's well-being. I have to say, if it was up to me, all of you would get your hero's license right here and now, because what you just dealt with was extremely dangerous and very real, but I do have some good news that does come out of this major tragedy. Zuko was trying his best to stay calm, even though he was truly angry on the inside. All I can say is this better be life-changing news, because so far this school makes me want to report everything to the authorities. Kenzo just felt so disappointed in UA for how they were treating them, but he was more concerned about carrying Titan's crystal on his back. I'm hoping that not all the teachers and faculty are like this, because whoever allowed this to happen should end up in jail. Mina was holding on to her sides, a little bit shocked and upset at the same time. This entire test was frightening. I almost died a couple of times, and I had to watch some of the people that I consider like family around me almost die. Yumi was thinking about how her mother is going to handle hearing about this. I'm actually concerned for the school board. When my mother finds out about how we were treated, she might go on a rampage herself. I never understood how each one of them felt, as he was concerned for each one of them at a different level, but he also felt like he had to be the voice of reason and joy. Well, the principal was actually watching the entire event, and he said if you were able to survive all the way to the end, you will automatically be accepted into the school. He was also very concerned for all of you. That's why he sent Overhaul ahead of us, so he can get here first. Zuko stepped in front of the entire group, only having two questions on his mind. I have a few questions for you before anything else is said and done. Endeavor was worried because he knew that any of these questions were unavoidable. Go ahead, I'll do my best to answer them within my ability. Zuko hesitated for a second on those questions because he felt like he already knew the answers, but then he remembered everything that he went through for the past hour, so he just wanted to get some straight facts. Did the other applicants in the other cities have to go through the same amount of chaos that we just went through? Endeavor had a grim look on his face because he didn't really want to give the truth to the five of them that they were nearly knocking on death's door while the rest of the applicants were actually having a fair testing site. I'm not going to lie to any of you, this was the only testing site that actually turned into an actual war zone while the rest were actually really well contained. Jinso actually walked up to Endeavor even more pissed about their entire situation. So you were watching us go through hell and you didn't try to stop the exam or at least talk to the others about getting it postponed so it could be a fair testing site? Endeavor looked at all of them with a very calm and emotionless face. To be honest, I believe that all of you could have handled the situation, but when I kept on watching the numbers growing rapidly and you kept on dropping one by one, I was regretting my choice, so I'm really sorry I didn't step in sooner. Izuku was completely enraged by what he just heard. You should have done something. I told you earlier today that if we couldn't get into the school, we could have gone somewhere else, but you decided to gamble our lives away. Kenzo was actually having flashbacks to every close call they had today, thinking about how Endeavor was just watching them and how he answered. Do you not even know that there's a chance we might not see Titan outside of that crystal? For all we know, we could be seeing him in suspended animation right now. Or even if it is fixing and we don't know how long he's going to be in there, whatever happened here today is going to be on your conscience because you had the power to stop all this. Mina was looking at both Izuku and Shinso, who were about to snap on Endeavor, until she grabbed onto the both of their heads and banged them together. Both of you need to stop and think about that. We're not the only ones hurting in this situation. How do you think Endeavor feels about how he decided to handle the situation today? He was worried about our lives while everybody else was laughing at our expense. Endeavor has been one of the last few Puro heroes that actually still have faith in us. He's been training us for years, trying to give us hope and confidence for this day. We need to look at this from an outside perspective. The only reason that he let this continue is because he believed that we would be able to pull through no matter what. As soon as he made that call, he had to live with the regret of watching us all drop like flies while the robots were trying to pick us apart piece by piece. The both of you actually have to apologize to Endeavor and realize that he's in just as much pain as we are about this whole thing. Jinso hung his head down, realizing that he let his emotions get out of control. You're right, and I'm very sorry, Endeavor. I'm just shocked and very upset about today. I took out all my frustration on the first person that I thought wasn't a part of any of it. Endeavor just nodded his head because he completely understood where Shinso was coming from. It's alright, I completely understand what's going through your head. Both of your statements are not wrong. I should have stepped in, but in the end, everything worked out, so let's just count our blessings and hope that Titan returns to our group really soon. Zuko didn't really care about what was going on. He had one final question that he had to answer before he could move on from any of this. What was All Might's reaction and phrasing while we were in here? Endeavor put his hand to his chin, remembering how All Might was acting very smug and seeming to wanting to end the exam before it even began. He seemed to be acting like he knew what was going to happen, but also making sure to stay vague about it at some times. But when everybody tried to go against the decision, he decided to get silently enraged, but I could tell that he was getting mad even though he was keeping it to himself. Zuko looked down at the ground as he started to walk away from everybody. I understand. I'll I'll talk to all of you later. There's something I have to go check out. Overhaul quickly put his hand on the ground, making a makeshift wall right in front of Izuku. If you're going to try and find All Might, let me just tell you this in advance. It's not going to be worth it. Izuku looked back at Overhaul with a very serious expression on his face. You do not get the right to tell me if it is worth it or not. For what he has caused for all of us today, he needs to answer for his crimes. While they were arguing, they could hear the prideful chuckle of a man in the air as he came crashing down below onto the street. The dust cloud dissipated, revealing All Might wearing his hero outfit as he had a signature grin on his face. Well, I'm glad to see that nobody's hurt and that you were actually able to pass the exam. I was one of the representatives of the school, and I'm actually here to tell you that you've been selected to be placed in Class 1A, the hero course, so make sure to continue to go plus ultra all the way. Overhaul started to shake his head like it was the worst time as he actually started to look around, realizing that all the other heroes actually already left. Quit with the fake gratitude and tell us why you're really here. All Might lost his trademark smile as he got a very serious look on his face. While I was sent by the school, I had to keep up a public image for everybody, but I also wanted to prove that I had nothing to do with this. I've been with the faculty ever since I have entered the UA building. Izuku had to fight back the urge to shoot All Might with his air cannon or one of his many other quirks, but he decided to restrain himself to try to figure out the situation. While I believe you had nothing to do with this, the moment I'm rotting in my grave, especially since Nairai was here and we're the only testing site that seemed to have any issues. All Might walked over to Izuku as he placed one of his hands on his shoulder. Even though I don't like the idea that you're going to be in the same class as my daughter, it's not up to me. And even if you try to keep on investigating, there is still a fact that you have no proof, so I would let it go while you're still ahead. Izuku was angry as he smacked All Might's hand off of his shoulder. I wish that Nana could see you right now and realize that you made the biggest mistake was trusting you, but then again, what do you expect from a psycho? All Might actually picked up Izuku by his shirt, ready to strangle the life out of him. How dare you speak ill of my predecessor? She was a true hero standing for justice, so bite your tongue, All for One. Everybody was getting ready to jump in, but then stopped as they heard the sound of a kind voice coming from the left side of the whole situation. When they all turned to see who it was, they saw that it was Principal Nezu along with Eraserhead. Nezu came out of Eraserhead's scarf as he was just looking down at All Might with a disappointed look. I would appreciate if you would actually take your hands off of that student, All Might. Her services right now are not required. Maybe you should go to your daughter and see how she is doing and leave these people alone. All Might let go of Izuku as he then turned to look at Nezu. I'm very sorry, sir. I lost my composure for a minute, but I will be heading off now to go see how my daughter did. All Might jumped off, leaving the entire testing site as Eraserhead and Nezu were walking closer to the entire group as they looked at each other, not ready to be yelled at by children. But they would understand if they did, as Eraserhead actually pulled out a clipboard and going over the results of the exam. I'm not going to lie, I am very sorry for all of you. If it was up to me, I would have fully stopped the testing site cold, but it was out of my hands. But I'm glad we didn't, because you all showed true forms of heroism and no hesitation on what you needed to do if this was actually really happening. Nezu jumped down to the ground as he was actually bowing towards the group of teens. As principal of the school, I take full responsibility and will do everything I can to provide proper medical help that you need. I intend to truly make all of this right because I was worried about all of you. Devra went over to Eraserhead so he can look over at the clipboard that he had. I'm guessing that some of those papers are their acceptance form along with some of the notes that you took while watching the exam. Eraserhead nodded as he then turned to look at Izuku. I have a lot of things I want to say to you about the exam. The first thing is, why were you not using all of your abilities? Because according to the previous research that I've done on you throughout the years, along with the paperwork that's been handed to me, you've not been using all the abilities that you have. I could have actually helped deal with half of the situation that you were in during the exam. Izuku was thinking about that, then realized there was a few things he could have done but didn't think of at the time. I guess the best way to say it, I wasn't very well practiced in every quirk that I have. Plus, I have some issues with a couple of them. Plus, if I push my body too far, I could end up becoming something I don't want to become. Eraserhead nodded as he actually wanted to get some more information but didn't feel like pushing the matter. I guess that's understandable. It's just something you'll have to learn when you're here at UA. But with that aside, would all of you like to hear your score? Yumi actually spoke up in excitement. I would actually like to hear my score, seeing where we all stand with one another. Yuna was actually curious about her score, hoping that she did better than she was expecting. Now let's see who got the most points so we can tell who gets to brag the most. Jinso was actually shrugging his shoulder, not really caring what his score was. I guess we might as well know. Izuku walked over to Titan's crystal, knowing that Titan would actually want to know his score. Yeah, I guess you should tell us, even though it doesn't really matter. Eraserhead flipped through his notes until he landed on the sheet that had the scores on it. Alright, I will say your name and and your points from the lowest to highest. The lowest out of all of you is Yumi with a score of 83 combat points and 42 rescue points. Yumi was pouting a little bit thinking about her score. Well, I guess that's not bad, but it really does suck to be the lowest out of everybody. Eraserhead flipped to the next page, actually ignoring the comment from Yumi. Right next is Shoto with 100 combat points and 30 rescue points. Shoto finally got full consciousness as he started to hear his name and his score as he realized that he was going to get a lot of trash talk being the second from the bottom. Okay, in fairness, I got knocked out early on in the test, so don't give me too much trash talk. Zuku spoke up while shaking his head. Trust me, I don't think anybody's going to be talking trash after everything we just went through, so just be happy to hear your score, so please continue, Eraserhead. Eraserhead just nodded his head as he flipped to the next page of his clipboard to see the score sheet. Alright, next is Mina with 90 combat points and 60 rescue points. Mina was happy knowing that she was at least middle of the group when it came to getting points. Wow, that's a lot higher than I thought, but we're about to hear the real high scores about now. Eraserhead actually flipped to the next page of his clipboard as he looked like he was totaling up some points that weren't added on earlier. Alright, next is Shinso with 85 combat points and 90 rescue points. Shinso was actually surprised that he had more rescue points than actual combat points. I didn't even realize that I did that much rescuing. I thought I was doing a lot more combat stuff than anything else. Mina was thinking back to the battle, realizing all the times that Shinso was watching over everybody, making sure that he gave them help. I really think that you need to realize how good of a rescue hero you really are. Shoto realized that there's only two people left, which actually caused him to wonder who had the most points because Titan had a lot of AoE attacks early on in the test. But Izuku had multiple people running around the testing site getting him points. This is actually going to be interesting because the last two people have a chance of going either way. Racer had flipped through his clipboard again and was actually surprised by the amount of points that the next person had. The next person is Titan with 175 combat points and 20 rescue points. Zuku smiled, expecting nothing less from Titan. Are any of us really surprised that he has a ton of combat points? What really surprises me that he has any rescue points. Eraserhead was actually going over his notes trying to figure out how Titan actually got any rescue points. He got those points trying to shield you guys early on in the test and then by saving Foxfire from the explosion by deploying himself from his transformation body. Shinsu remembered that, but then he also thought to himself that Titan should have been awarded a few more rescue points for all the things that he did, but it didn't really matter in the end. Well, he always liked to act like the big tank and take all the big hits, so at least he was rewarded for it. Never was shocked to hear so many high scores because he wasn't really trying to pay attention to the point value during the exam. Much as I would like to hear people comment about this even further, we have to still hear the top slot. Eraserhead yawned a little bit as he flipped through his notes a little bit as he was trying to get the final tally. Last but not least is Izuku with 250 combat points and 150 rescue points, actually shattering a school record. But of course, this score is underneath a very drastic situation, but it does not belittle the fact that you scored so high. You all should be very proud of yourselves. You have a very bright future in the hero industry. Endeavor gathered all of the kids' attention, making sure that they were listening to him. Come on, we'll head back home. We'll let everybody know how you did so we can have a big party, and hopefully by then Titan will be awake. Zuku had a funny thought as he started to chuckle out loud a little bit. Bet you if Mom tells him that she's making his favorite food, he'll bust out of that crystal so fast we don't even know what happened. That's where I'm gonna leave it off this time, guys. Make sure to leave a like and comment down below, and check out our Discord board. All that said, I'm out this time, guys. Bye.